Breaking, China makes shocking announcement over whose side they're on. In an epic blast to integrity, China has declared where it really stands on the matter of America versus North Korea. While their stance is understandable, it is no less mind-boggling. With one sentence, they both condone and condemn actions taken by either country should one choose to shoot. It would effectively hold most in a locked standoff position, but it is apparent that Kim Jong-un isn't smart enough to utilize what China stated to their advantage. On the other hand, it is especially offensive due to the reality that America almost never acts aggressively. Almost never. While I am often for preemptive strikes, I also often stand on this side of defense only. China didn't even have to make the statement they did. That stance has been pretty well known for quite some time, and was basically only made to shut up the masses asking what would China do. China will do nothing. Just like they never do anything other than talk big and show small. North Korea is a worldwide threat regardless of where they aim or fire their missiles. Any strike by Kim Jong-un will be seen as an attack on the global platform by many after the fact when other leaders fully take in the implications of said attacks and the rhetoric will change. According to Chinese state media, the Chinese should stay neutral if North Korea strikes at the U.S. first but will respond with force if the U.S. strikes North Korea. Axios.com reported. A state-run newspaper has argued in an editorial that China should remain neutral if North Korea attacks the U.S., but intervene forcefully if the U.S. strikes first. Excerpt via Reuters. It needs to make clear its stance to all sides and make them understand that when their actions jeopardize China's interests, China will respond with a firm hand. China should also make clear that if North Korea launches missiles that threaten U.S. soil first and the U.S. retaliates, China will stay neutral. If the U.S. and South Korea carry out strikes and try to overthrow the North Korean regime and change the political pattern of the Korean Peninsula, China will prevent them from doing so. A word of caution, while the newspaper, The Global Times, is published by the official party organ, The People's Daily, it should not be interpreted as official governmental policy. China has a coward's call more or less when it comes to starting anything regardless of who started it. So their latest announcement should come as no big shocker to anyone. Nor should it be a true threat to what Trump plans to do. Our president is very well aware of every tiny nuance that will go into a move made in either direction and is quite capable of making the correct and safe decision based on intelligence. Fear-mongering and dictatorial threats are typical at this stage in any possible conflict, and while it is a sure thing that Trump is holding them as quite serious, he is one of few in our history that will make his choice based on factual dangers and not power-slamming leaders with ego issues. Basically, it's all a worldwide, ball-measuring contest, and only one world leader needs to make the decision to actually lead with his head and do the right thing regardless of what others may spew prior to the actions. North Korea has been a huge issue the world over for generations, and it is time that their nuclear blackmail be stopped and not negotiated with as before. If this somehow offends China based on whatever black market dealings it is known to have with Kim Jong-un, then that is their problem. It is likely that any retribution by China is being quite thoroughly planned for at this time, as well as what tactics to use with North Korea. We wanted a president who would do what was right, not what was popular. And we got one, so let's let him do his job. Prayers up for intelligent and speedy decisions as well as clean and concise reasoning. God bless America, America. Breaking, China makes shocking announcement over whose side they're on. In an epic blast to integrity, China has declared where it really stands on the matter of America versus North Korea. While their stance is understandable, it is no less mind-boggling. With one sentence, they both condone and condemn actions taken by either country should one choose to shoot. It would effectively hold most in a locked standoff position, but it is apparent that Kim Jong-un isn't smart enough to utilize what China stated to their advantage. On the other hand, it is especially offensive due to the reality that America almost never acts aggressively. Almost never. While I am often for preemptive strikes, I also often stand on this side of defense only. China didn't even have to make the statement they did. That stance has been pretty well known for quite some time, and was basically only made to shut up the masses asking what would China do. China will do nothing. Just like they never do anything other than talk big and show small. North Korea is a worldwide threat regardless of where they aim or fire their missiles. Any strike by Kim Jong-un will be seen as an attack on the global platform by many after the fact when other leaders fully take in the implications of said attacks and the rhetoric will change. According to Chinese state media, the Chinese should stay neutral if North Korea strikes at the U.S. first but will respond with force if the U.S. strikes North Korea. Axios.com reported. A state-run newspaper has argued in an editorial that China should remain neutral if North Korea attacks the U.S., but intervene forcefully if the U.S. strikes first. Excerpt via Reuters. It needs to make clear its stance to all sides and make them understand that when their actions jeopardize China's interests, China will respond with a firm hand. China should also make clear that if North Korea launches missiles that threaten U.S. soil first and the U.S. retaliates, China will stay neutral. If the U.S. and South Korea carry out strikes and try to overthrow the North Korean regime and change the political pattern of the Korean Peninsula, China will prevent them from doing so. A word of caution, while the newspaper, the Global Times, is published by the official party organ, the People's Daily, it should not be interpreted as official governmental policy. China has a coward's call more or less when it comes to starting anything regardless of who started it. So their latest announcement should come as no big shock or to anyone. Nor should it be a true threat to what Trump plans to do. Our president is very well aware of every tiny nuance that will go into a move made in either direction and is quite capable of making the correct and safe decision based on intelligence. Fear-mongering and dictatorial threats are typical at this stage in any possible conflict, and while it is a sure thing that Trump is holding them as quite serious, he is one of few in our history that will make his choice based on factual dangers and not power-slamming leaders with ego issues. Basically, it's all a worldwide, ball-measuring contest, and only one world leader needs to make the decision to actually lead with his head and do the right thing regardless of what others may spew prior to the actions. North Korea has been a huge issue the world over for generations, and it is time that their nuclear blackmail be stopped and not negotiated with as before. If this somehow offends China based on whatever black market dealings it is known to have with Kim Jong-un, then that is their problem. It is likely that any retribution by China is being quite thoroughly planned for at this time, as well as what tactics to use with North Korea. We wanted a president who would do what was right, not what was popular. And we got one, so let's let him do his job. Prayers up for intelligent and speedy decisions as well as clean and concise reasoning. God bless America, America. Breaking, China makes shocking announcement over whose side they're on. In an epic blast to integrity, China has declared where it really stands on the matter of America versus North Korea. While their stance is understandable, it is no less mind-boggling. With one sentence, they both condone and condemn actions taken by either country should one choose to shoot. It would effectively hold most in a locked standoff position, but it is apparent that Kim Jong-un isn't smart enough to utilize what China stated to their advantage. On the other hand, it is especially offensive due to the reality that America almost never acts aggressively. Almost never. While I am often for preemptive strikes, I also often stand on this side of defense only. China didn't even have to make the statement they did. That stance has been pretty well known for quite some time, and was basically only made to shut up the masses asking what would China do. China will do nothing. Just like they never do anything other than talk big and show small. North Korea is a worldwide threat regardless of where they aim or fire their missiles. Any strike by Kim Jong-un will be seen as an attack on the global platform by many after the fact when other leaders fully take in the implications of said attacks and the rhetoric will change. According to Chinese state media, The Chinese should stay neutral if North Korea strikes at the U.S. first, but will respond with force if the U.S. strikes North Korea. Axios.com reported. A state-run newspaper has argued in an editorial that China should remain neutral if North Korea attacks the U.S., but intervene forcefully if the U.S. strikes first. Excerpt via Reuters. It needs to make clear its stance to all sides and make them understand that when their actions jeopardize China's interests, China will respond with a firm hand. China should also make clear that if North Korea launches missiles that threaten U.S. soil first and the U.S. retaliates, China will stay neutral. If the U.S. and South Korea carry out strikes and try to overthrow the North Korean regime and change the political pattern of the Korean Peninsula, China will prevent them from doing so. A word of caution, while the newspaper, the Global Times, is published by the official party organ, the People's Daily, it should not be interpreted as official governmental policy. China has a coward's call more or less when it comes to starting anything regardless of who started it. So their latest announcement should come as no big shocker to anyone. Nor should it be a true threat to what Trump plans to do. Our president is very well aware of every tiny nuance that will go into a move made in either direction and is quite capable of making the correct and safe decision based on intelligence. Fear-mongering and dictatorial threats are typical at this stage in any possible conflict, and while it is a sure thing that Trump is holding them as quite serious, he is one of few in our history that will make his choice based on factual dangers and not power-slamming leaders with ego issues. Basically, it's all a worldwide, ball-measuring contest, and only one world leader needs to make the decision to actually lead with his head and do the right thing regardless of what others may spew prior to the actions. North Korea has been a huge issue the world over for generations, and it is time that their nuclear blackmail be stopped and not negotiated with as before. If this somehow offends China based on whatever black market dealings it is known to have with Kim Jong-un, then that is their problem. It is likely that any retribution by China is being quite thoroughly planned for at this time, as well as what tactics to use with North Korea. We wanted a president who would do what was right, not what was popular. And we got one, so let's let him do his job. Prayers up for intelligent and speedy decisions, as well as clean and concise reasoning. God bless America, America.